there's a lot of media out there, obviously. Media exists all the time, everywhere around us. And sometimes, maybe sometimes, those off chances, okay, I'm being a little sarcastic, those off chances that media can just surprise you and be a little negative on housing. And again, we've talked about this, but what we haven't yet unpacked is the impact that a negative perspective on housing should have and should not have on the investor's perspective, on the investor's mindset. And to me, holy cow, that can be dangerous because there's always going to be ups and downs and ins and outs, but we need to be steadfast in our thinking. Greg, what do you think, man? Am I talking truth or am I full of it?
You're speaking truth, buddy. It's important to be accurate. Okay. So let me just preface it by saying that being negative when negative is appropriate is the right thing. Okay.
Being positive
when it's a bad idea, is also wrong. And the issue today is that, like you talked about media, you made the sort of joke, the tongue-in-cheek comment about media having a horse in every race, right? And it's just where we are today, right? It's if you like one politician, then you think one channel is fake news and the other one is the Bible. And then if you like the other politician, that one's fake news. And this one over here is the Bible. And so in politics, we see it glaringly. But in financial news, I feel like politics is sort of cut across into somebody else's lane here. And it does have the ability. I can give you examples of mistakes that people make when they believe negativity, when negativity is not warranted. Okay. So I'll give you one right now.
Let's do it.
Like right now today, the housing market is doing very well. There is a headline that I'm looking at right now for Inman News where the headline is Zillow experts predict a recession will hit in 2020. Okay. And the graphic behind the headline, if you want to search this when you get out of your car or if you're walking your dog, you go search the word Inman, I-N-M-A-N, and then the word recession, and you'll see, or Zillow recession, you'll see 8,000 stories about this prediction of a recession and the innuendo that what it means is a housing crisis. And by the way, you go deeper into the story, not very deep, you go pretty shallow in the story, and you find that more than half of the experts they surveyed did not predict a recession, but they decided to run with the headline that nearly half the experts surveyed said, like,
I'm looking at this article too, and I see like the economic crisis big graphic in the background. It's like, what?
Yeah, it's just gratuitous. It's gratuitous and it's gross and it's misleading. So this is one of those times where it's an advantage to you as an investor to know your own stuff. Right. Understand we make so much housing data transparent. And we talk about this a lot here because I want you to protect your optimism because right now it is totally appropriate to be optimistic. When you see people twisting themselves into pretzels to come up with ways to paint today's housing market as bad, or in this case, to survey 100 experts, have 40 of them say we're hitting a recession in 2 years and then say that the experts say we're hitting a recession. That's like, you know, 100 meteorologists saying it's, you know, 40 of them saying it's going to rain, 60 says it's going to be sunny out, and then you come out with the prediction that it's going to rain. Like, why would you do that? Why would you do that? That's a different question for a different segment.
Right.
But why does it hurt you? Why does it hurt you as an investor? And for example, you don't buy right now. If you believe this, you don't buy, you wait. Here's something you can take to the bank. Any property you buy during the recession that they say is coming in 2020 is going to cost you more than if you bought it today. Prices are going up between now and 2020, between now and 2025. Okay, that recession may be true in terms of the classic definition of recession that the GDP is going to go flat and it's not going to grow for a couple of quarters in a row, not going to have any impact on the housing market. Housing market is moving according to population growth. Okay, so I saw something just yesterday posted by a friend on Facebook, who is a real estate investment expert, who I thought it was very forward of him, or straightforward of him and forthright, because he said, I guess that was wrong, he wrote, and he showed a flashback to a post he made in 2013. His post in 2013 was hair on fire, market's going to collapse, this feel like the housing bust of 10 years ago, run away, run away, run away. Well, if you ran away from the housing market, according to that advice back in 2013, you lost.
Yep.
You missed a phenomenal run. Now, we were saying that the market is going to do really, really well, that we're down below the trend line right now, that all the indicators are positive, and we have all this positive room to catch up right now to where we should have been if not for this big bust that we just came through, that was totally the right advice. Now, you could give my buddy a pass because he might have been watching experts with quotes on CNBC talking about how the market's a wreck, and for whatever reason they came up with that day to say the housing market is a wreck, they said it. He bought it. He amplified it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. My computer made a funny noise there. He amplified it. And if you listen to that advice, you actually lost. So there's a tangible example of where people take advice of negativity where it's not warranted and miss a big opportunity.
You know what drives me crazy, right? It's like the tech bubble in the early 2000s, okay? You owned a bunch of stock, for example, and you got all frustrated because that's what you do, right? Lemmings die. So you became a lemming. You turned yourself into a lemming, and better yet, you set your own hair on fire and decided, you know what? I'm going to sell my stock because I'm worried that the U.S. economy is going to just bottom out, right? Guess what happened? You lost value. If you sold your portfolio, you lost money. You're out the door. You're out of the game. But if you didn't sell, you didn't lose your stock. You just lost value. Fine. Guess where we are now, right? Like,
yeah,
you have to just hang on, folks, right? Like, stop.
Yeah, be patient.
Right. Patience
have
is not a thing, though.
Have your expectations be long-term.
Listen, Greg, I'm part of microwave society here, brother, right? Like, I want patience, and I want it right now, right? I want to go on Instagram and find patience using a hashtag and say, give it to me.
Yep, and you're stomping your feet saying, I want it now.
Exactly.
And I get it. And the idea, like, I'll give you a beautiful another example that we tracked and we documented real well, so I can back this up also. And that is that a few years ago, when gas prices, oil prices were plummeting, and gas prices were plummeting too. And don't forget, when gas prices were rising, that was a reason to be terrified and hair on fire, right? Now gas prices right. were declining, and guess what? Hair's on fire again. Houston is going to hell in a handbasket because Houston is an oil city. Oil prices are down. Houston is ruined, okay? There were articles in the Houston Chronicle, people lamenting how Houston's in big trouble, except for the fact that we had the data that showed that the oil industry is part of a minority segment of jobs in Houston. Houston is like Dallas. Population is going there for everything, not just the oil industry. So we said Houston's a buy, right? It was. Houston kicked butt during that period of time. And guess what happened? They got hit by the hurricane. What did everybody say? Houston's ruined. No one's ever going to buy, and you should never invest there. They're hurricane prone. Stay out of Houston. Investors swooped in, put a lot of capital into fixing Houston very quickly, opportunistic. Maybe people would say vulturistic, but you know what? They came in with a lot of money, fixed this place up. It's gone a long way in a short period of time.
Mm-hmm.
But people wrote it off as dead. Current headlines, Houston's awesome. Best investment in the country. It's on everybody's top 10 list, and it's awesome. And it was very predictable that it would be awesome because the fundamentals for Houston, the bedrock fundamentals are, it's a huge southern city with a high quality of life and a low cost of living. Companies are relocating there like crazy. People relocating there like crazy. And when gas prices go down, yes, the oil companies have trouble with their stock. And yes, they may do some layoffs, okay? But a whole lot of people consume a whole lot more gasoline, so their product flies off the shelves. In the end, the energy industry being an anchor of the economy down in Houston is something to pay attention to, but the economy is so diverse down there that all those calls of demise were flat out wrong. So you have to look at the source, and if the source has been wrong before, figure they're probably wrong now too.
Hey Greg, I have an idea. Because Houston is so hot right now and everybody loves Houston, let's start creating articles about how there's a bubble in Houston. Oh, wait a minute. That's probably already happening.
That would be fake news, bro.
I know.